Welcome to General Issues.
We have issues.
It's Groundhog's Day. Happy Groundhog's Day.
Yeah, that fat fucking stupid Punxsutawney Paul or whatever saw his shadow again.
I think his name's still Phil.
Whatever.
I think in honor of Groundhog's Day, we should just keep repeating the same thing over and over again.
Oh, and then the guy from Brooklyn Bob, that ant rodent, he did not see his shadow, so that means...
It's a rat, probably.
But the Teenage Mutant Ninjas, when they came out of the sewer, they didn't see their shadow either. So that means there's going to be spring right around the corner.
Woo!
I'm so excited.
It's been spring all winter, though.
Yeah.
So how mad can we be?
I'm okay with that. Oh, we want to give a shout out to Ricky, Kyle, Jen, Vic, Liz, the birthday girl.
Yeah, Liz just had her birthday. Happy birthday, Liz. You're still young
she
to me.
Turned 16 or?
Yeah, like three times. No, not three times.
Wait. What's going on?
No, she's 29 again.
Well, it's Thursday, February 2nd, just in case you're an idiot and you don't know. And it's 9:02 now.
9:02.
So we want you to call us at 888-668-0742. You can download an app. It's really cool. You download it. You do a search for TuneIn Radio. Do a search for MSC Radio, and then you can listen to it on your dumb phone, and you can email us at generalissues@gmail.com, and then
Definitely join us in the chat room.
Unless
you're that guy that keeps trying to get us to sign up for Viagra or whatever porn site.
Please
he's
stop.
Bending.
Why would we need Viagra?
We don't want you to come on the chat room
We're
anymore.
In our prime. We don't need that. We just date younger guys, so they don't need it. So stop.
And you can, of course, always find us on the Twitter. And on facebook.com/generalissues. So we'll be looking forward to that.
So, they came out with a trailer for the Avengers.
I love trailer parks.
Of course you do. So I thought it was funny. I'm going to show you guys this real quick. We're going to go to a video, Chris.
Can you see me? I was an extra. I was not an
here
extra.
Here we go. Right here.
Yes. Cleveland.
That's not. Is that Cleveland? No, I don't. That doesn't look familiar. That's it. Yeah, we got a big shout out there. I mean, that was total bullshit, if you ask me. That's it? That's all you're going to put in the trailer? That wasn't even our buildings, I don't think.
I don't think so.
That was a green screen, I think, of cool buildings. But anyways.
Hey, we're making a mark in Hollywood.
Sure we are. But you couldn't tell.
I think it's like isn't it the cheapest place next to Detroit to film a movie? That's only, and everybody's moved away, so they have all this extra space to film shit downtown?
Probably.
They want to take advantage of all the buildings before they knock them down.
I actually know a person that called off work to be an extra in that movie, and I bet you won't even see. I mean, the person lost her job. And everything, but she probably won't even be in the video, or the video, I'm sorry, the movie. Anywho, so what's going on? What are your issues today, this week, or whatever?
Well, as always, I do have a few. I found an interesting story that I just loved, because I thought it was awesome. There is a store in Brooklyn, New York, called Babeland.
Brooklyn in-house, New York.
Okay, sorry. So Babeland is taking delivery to a whole new level. You know how you call, you order your pizza on a Friday night, and you get your delivery in 30 minutes or less? Well, Babeland is offering you the opportunity to order condoms, lubricants, and whatever kind of sex toy you might fancy for the evening. So if you time it right.
Okay, so wait a minute. So do they have this because they're trying to promote safe sex?
No, I think just good times.
Okay, great.
So if you can cue up the picture there, Jen, and show us our...
I got it right here. There's the picture.
So
there she is.
Yeah, they've partnered with a courier service, so you actually get your dildo on a bike. And this woman looks very happy to have the job that she's got. So
she probably makes a shit ton of money.
Kudos to her.
You know what? She probably goes in there and helps them out and gives them like instructions. I don't know.
So if you time it right on a Friday night, I figure you call Domino's and be like, you know, it's going to be there in 30 minutes or less. So this Babeland guarantees delivery within an hour. It is $30 for delivery.
Uh-huh.
Free on Valentine's Day.
Oh, that's coming up, right?
That is very much coming up, like very, very soon.
Week and a half or something. Yeah, so you call them up, they give you a deal, or you could be like,
I want a clit flicker stat.
I want the rabbit now. Rabbit. Anyways,
so I have to figure out how to turn this down. I don't know what's going on here.
Cool. It's mute. The mute button.
Oh my God! How smart are you?
To the right. Right. Oh, never mind. We'll talk about that later.
We'll talk about that later. But anyway, all this stories about sex toys. It actually coincided with my 5-year-old daughter. discovering one in my drawer, my nightstand.
Are you serious?
Yeah, she discovers one in my nightstand, and she tells me, Mom, look what I found. I don't know what this is. I said, what were you doing in my nightstand? She said, I was looking for my blue Play-Doh. I'm pretty certain that your blue Play-Doh is not in my drawer, but the good news is that sex toys are a lot more discreet than they used to be.
How so?
They don't really look like, I mean, I would never own a sex toy that looks like a giant penis.
You getting a giant penis in your vagina as we speak?
No. No, couldn't be farther from the truth.
Oh.
But I was Jillian's age, I was about 5 or 6, I went rifling through my mom's dresser and found her vibrator. And vibrators back in the day were pretty they were just like these kind of like off-white rocket ship looking. And they just had the knob on the bottom and you turned them. So my brother had just been born, and I was really pissed off that I wasn't getting any of that new baby attention. I'm like this 5 or 6 year old kid that's had all the attention my whole life and no one's paying any attention to me.
Mm-hmm.
So my parents had a welcome new baby dinner party, and I went upstairs to play by myself and pout, and I found this rocket ship in my mom's drawer, and I thought it was the most awesome thing ever. So during the dinner party, like right after the salad, I come screaming down the stairs with Barbie perched on the top of the rocket ship, yelling blast off.
Right.
And I had painted USA on the side with my mom's red nail polish.
Okay.
So my mom, I'm confused. My mom starts crying. I think she peed her pants a little bit.
Who wouldn't?
I'm like, what is going on? I'm like, you know, looking back on it even, I'm like, at least I had Barbie working for NASA.
Right. I won't say that, really. I won't say that that something very similar happened to me, but I didn't touch it, and I start crying when I saw it.
I didn't know what the hell it was.
When I saw somebody, I can't really.
One time I accidentally brought one to the airport.
Okay, how do you accidentally put a dildo?
Well, here's the thing. I had just moved, and I didn't want my friends that were moving us to see any of my unmentionables in my drawer, so I put it in my purse, and I forgot it was there, and I had taken a flight like 2 days later, and it got discovered at the security checkpoint.
So they threw it away?
It was right after 9/11, and I think I'm still on the dildo terror watch list.
Right.
So one last quick thing. There are a bunch of different websites. If you're not comfortable, you know, walking in and doing it the way God intended, going into a porno store and getting the, you know, dildo in a nondescript black porno bag, you can order from a number of sites online. And I had a girlfriend that I was kind of trying to counsel after she got a divorce, letting her know that it was completely okay. Everybody does it. And she's been missing the boat for so many years. So she's, you know, late 30s, has never owned a sex toy.
Oh, crap.
So she,
I hate women like that. You know what that means.
Oh, she doesn't want to listen.
Missionary.
Yeah, she doesn't want to listen to it. So I finally convinced her. I said, you know, you really need to explore this. So about 12 Miller Lights later, at home one night by herself, she logs on to a site called shoperotic.com and orders herself a bunch of sex toys, and she has no idea what she's doing. So a couple nights later, her and I come home from the bar, and there's this, like, you know, plain, like, brown paper wrapping box sitting on her porch, and it's full of all these sex toys. So I start rifling through them. And of course, I'm, you know, judging. I'm like, what? The clit flicker? What the hell is this? You know, like, why did you order this giant penis with a suction cup on the end of it? And then there was a little bag of anal beads that appeared nowhere on the receipt.
Ow.
So she's like, I don't know what I'm doing. Yeah, I don't know what I'm doing. You have to help me. And I said, okay. So I go onto their website and I'm like, well, we got to find out what the return policy is. So I look at the, and they're like, just send a letter stating the reason that you're unsatisfied with the product. So I've been drinking tequila and I'm like, I log on as her, of course, in her email account, and I write this letter to the sex toy industry.
So, oh God. All right.
I write, dear erotic peeps, thank you so much for the speedy processing of my erotic sex toy order. In my state of inebriation, I inadvertently ordered something called the clit flicker. After thoughtful consideration and some time to sober up, turns out I'm fully capable of flicking my own clit, so I won't be needing it. As far as the suction cup vibrator, it seems as though that would only work on surfaces such as windows. I'm not sure neighbors or people in passing cars on the morning commute would appreciate that. If I ever invest in a glass top coffee table, I might reconsider, but for now, it just isn't practical. It was very thoughtful of you to include the complimentary anal beads, but I just wouldn't feel right keeping those. Thanks again for providing the superior level of customer service one would only expect from the pornography industry. She did get a full refund, by the way.
Did she? Well, that's good.
So if you're ever in the need for a sex toy, I definitely recommend shoperotic.com because their customer service is top notch.
How do I go from anal beads to don't date your coworker? Anybody?
Unless they have anal beads.
Oh, Jen, I'm going to kill you. So. What is that? Oh, okay. So, 7 reasons to never date your coworker. I mean, I've done this before in the past. It was a total nightmare. It's totally taboo. It's hot, and the thrill of getting caught crosses your mind. But who cares? Because for women, we think, this is it. This is going to be the guy I marry, and he makes money. And no, and the guy's just thinking, hey, it's an easy lay, so I'm going to do it, and it's accessible. It's right there. We could do it in the car on our break. But so here are the reasons why you should not date your coworker.
On our break.
What, nobody does that? Okay. So keeping it a secret is virtually impossible. If you give two shits about your career and you want to preserve your work environment, it's a necessity that you at least try to keep your dating life secret. People always want to know other people's business. Am I right? I mean, that's the nature of...
I want to know everyone's business.
Yeah. I mean, that's why reality TV is so like popular, because you want to know other people's business. So good luck with that. It's not going to work. So that's one reason why you shouldn't, because you're never going to be able to keep a secret, especially if you're dating the girl with the biggest mouth or the guy that wants to, hey, guess who I banged? The girl with the big boobs and accounting. Anyways.
Accounting. People never have big boobs.
I know, right?
That's an oxymoron.
Oh, and then you work with the people who are nosy. Everybody's at the water cooler on Monday trying to find out other people's business. So you're going to be in everybody's mouth. That's one reason. Another reason why you shouldn't date somebody in the workplace is because you're going to be the topic of conversation.
Somebody in the chat room says he used to work for Scene Magazine and he banged everyone that worked there.
That's a fucking lie, Gabe Simon. You're a liar.
All right. I might have made that up.
Is that DX Ferris?
Oh, DX. Oh, my God. I haven't heard that name. That's a blast from the past. The nosy people are going to be like, how's your relationship? Are you guys getting married? What's wrong? Are you guys fighting? I haven't seen you guys talk to each other. You didn't take a smoke break. Ugh. You're just like, fuck off. We were just banging. We were drunk. We even got wine. Okay. So the next reason is your reputation is shot. Before you started dating this person, people in the office came to you because you were an expert at your job. Openly dating your coworker will transform you from honor employee to horn dog or slut. So negative attention is bad attention in the workplace. So you definitely want to keep that in mind. Unless you're quitting, then fuck it. Have fun. Okay.
Or unless you work at like Burger King, because then you should bang everyone.
or McDonald's. We like McDonald's. So we're just going to say that. Personal stuff at the workplace. Another career killer is the time bomb of personal affairs exploding in the office place. Not saying that it will happen, but it could. Imagine how bad it would look if you got caught fighting with your lady friend or your douchebag friend. Forget about the nosy people or your jealous dude is mad that you're talking to the UPS guy. You need to be thinking about management. Personal eruptions are never cool in the workplace. This will definitely reflect. So basically, if you guys are going to fight, go behind the building. Then you can fight. Or use company email.
Or get the other person fired.
Oh, yeah. I've tried to do that before. No, I'm just kidding. Anyways. Boredom. Come on. Who wants to see the person they're dating all day, every day? You're stuck with that person for 40 hours plus every week. Then you have to see them on the weekends, too. Oh, fuck that. When do you get a break? Constant proximity is the quickest way to killing a relationship. So why bother date someone you work with? The allure will die out soon enough. Anyways, because it always does, doesn't it? And then workplace jealousy. Oh, yeah, this is true. What if you moved up in the company and she's stuck getting lattes for her boss, or he's in the mailroom stuffing mailboxes contemplating on how he's going to bang your bestie at work? Either way it goes, workplace competition is brutal, so why fuck it up with this? Huh? Jen, any comments?
I would have to agree. I don't ever date people where I work.
Well.
It's a bad idea.
Well.
What are you saying, that nobody where I work is dateable?
I didn't say that.
Including me.
And the last but not least, what if you guys break up? Nothing is guaranteed, especially your dumbass work relationship. And when this are... What was that? Excuse me. What the hell was that? And I don't know what that was. If and when this hookup fails, you'll be stuck looking at this chick or dumbass dude at work, which sucks. just looking at each other, like in each other's cubicle. 40 grueling hours a week, he or she will be right there, pissed off that you dumped them, or vice versa. There's nothing you can do about it either, unless, of course, you're getting job offers from other places, from McDonald's. Yes, it's better than you never date a coworker in the first place. Save yourself the hassle. Keep it moving, bitches. That's all I have to say about that.
I think there's some very good points there.
I think so, too. I really mean, you've never dated one person you worked with?
Oh, I didn't say that. I've never done it.
I'm
saying that it has been a disaster and I will never do it again.
No. Maybe dating is not the right word. Have you ever banged a person you worked with?
Today. No, I'm just kidding. I did not do that. I swear to God, I did not.
That's why we were late.
Kidding. No.
Okay, so yes, no.
Yes, I actually married somebody I worked with.
Oh, crap.
And that worked out famously.
Horribly. So we actually, last week we talked about moms and we got cut off because Chris cuts us off after an hour. So we're going to bring this back up. We're going to talk about moms and single moms and moms on birth control. But I just have a quick video that I'm going to show you, Chris. Whatever. Here we go. I love that video. I'm cutting that off. I love that video. I'm sorry. How many moms? You're all stressed out. You're trying to get to the store.
I was so confused for a second there. I'm like, did that just happen?
This is why retarded people shouldn't have kids.
Exactly. That's what leads us to our next story, because some people should not have children. And if you do, you should give them up for adoption.
Everyone should start wearing a condom immediately. Mm. Based primarily on a news release by Pfizer, manufacturer of birth control pills, that had to recall 1 million birth control pills. For men who don't know, the way the birth control pills work, there's a number of them that are real birth control pills, and then there's like the placebo fake bullshit that goes into the package. Well, they screwed some of them up.
Oh my God.
On the days where you think that your ovaries are getting shot like an asteroid game, they're not.
Oh, good. Are you serious?
So they reverse some of them, and the risk of pregnancy obviously increases when you're actually not taking anything but a Tic Tac. So that's pretty much the problem. And they've
that's why you should switch and do the other things.
vaginally.
Butt sex? Are you endorsing butt sex here?
I'm endorsing the NuvaRing and the thing that looks like a fucking T. Put that up there. You don't get pregnant for 5 years. But you have to, yeah, guys. Get your chick into that.
I'm seeing a lot of trapping going on with this pill.
Yeah, but you know what? The good news is it's still, if you take the pill, it still does increase your risk of heart attack and or stroke. So that's good.
Shit! For those of you who don't know, I got a text message from Jennifer today saying that she might have another stroke. And I'm like, I'm not even responding to that. So good, if you didn't know this.
False alarm.
She made it through her 1 year anniversary of her having a stroke. I know people are probably like, asshole. You don't understand when you go out drinking with someone that's had a stroke and they could have a stroke at any moment. You're like, oh, fuck. And
we did celebrate.
Yeah.
Who else gets to have a stroke-iversary? That's a pretty cool day.
Stroke-iversary! So I had to carry around what to do when your friend's having a stroke, 1 through 5, which all
your
of those.
Your face looks droopy. No, that's just,
she had 5 shots. How the fuck am I supposed to know the difference between her face being droopy and her just being drunk? Can somebody please call me and let me know? I'm not trying to be an asshole. I just need to know these things. So when I get a text message saying, my fingers are tingly, hopefully I will make it past 2 p.m. Like,
My exact words were, I hope I don't get life flighted. In the event that I have to get life flighted, I might have a problem making the 9 p.m. start time.
So if you guys, it's just me 1 week, we could totally do it. We'll do it in the ER. Let's do it. We'll bring the camp. Chris, can you make this mobile?
Yeah, everything here at MSC is mobile.
Yes.
She'll
be like, oh, issue.
I can't wait to go back and visit all my 85-year-old friends I made.
Yeah.
It's a good time.
That's messed up.
I know.
Let's take a... Can we take a break?
Yeah,
can,
we got to take a break. This is...
And when we come back, let's talk about something uplifting like crime.
Yes.
Yay. It's National Crime Prevention Month in February.
That's
Who
right.
saw that coming?
I did because I looked it up last week.
See you in a little bit. Is that
the keywords?
Yes.
Break now.
Supplement Studio. You're listening
to Morning Show Central Radio Network.
Call the show toll free 1-888-668-0742. You're listening to Morning Show Central Radio Network on morningshowcentral.com.
Around the corner, voted best place to get wings and best outdoor patio, is the place for you and your friends if you like great live music, awesome pub food, or if you want to just kick back with friends on the enclosed heated patio. This neighborhood favorite hosts cornhole tournaments, crab races, and has tons of TVs to watch your favorite sports teams. Around the corner, located at 18616 Detroit Avenue, Lakewood, Ohio. Hey, want to guest bartend and raise money for a charity, organization, fundraiser, or your sports team? Call Ryan at 216-521-4413. That's 216-521-4413. The people have spoken. Get down to ATC and let the fun begin.
Check out Uncensored Net Noise every Friday night, 9 p.m. Eastern, right here. Uncensored Net Noise on MorningShowCentral.com. If you live the lifestyle, then you should arrive in style. Lifestyle Limousine Service. Whether it's dinner for two, an evening at the winery, or a night out on the town, Lifestyle Limousine provides extraordinary service. Check them out on the web, lifestylelimousineservice.com. Reserve your ride now, 330-903-0508, 330-903-0508. Lifestyle Limousine Service. And make sure you tell them Morning Show Central Radio Network sent you. Cocaine Energy Supplement. Due to great consumer demand, Redux Beverages has officially announced the return of its world-famous Cocaine Energy Supplement. It's now available at retail locations across the country, as well as online at ReduxDirect.com. That's ReduxDirect.com. Don't forget to be part of the all-new Cocaine Energy Supplement social network, where you can meet other Cocaine Energy Supplement fans from around the world. Cocaine Energy Supplement. You can become a member.
logging on to lovecocaine.com. Peak 99 Technologies.
Affordable and reliable web hosting done right.
Jumping from one web host to another can be frustrating.
Finding a good web host can be unnerving for even the most experienced of web designers.
That's why Uncensored Net Noise has chosen P99 Technologies as its web hosting supplier. Established in 1999,
P99 Technologies has evolved into a first-class web hosting provider.
Its 99.9% uptime rivals many in the industry. That's why they offer their 30-day guarantee.
No questions asked.
For more information, go to P99.com. P99 Technologies will help you get started with your web presence
with honest and expert customer service.
P99 Technologies. Affordable and reliable web hosting done right.
Coming at you from the rock and roll capital, it's an exciting and fast-paced global forum
with the man who knows how to help get your band even better.
Yeah! Doc Rock tackles industry issues with informed guests
and invites your questions, concerns, and tales of band life.
There's never a dull moment in Doc's world of showbiz.
He cares about artist issues and escalating your talents.
So make an appointment with Doc Rock on Band-Aid.
Thank you!
Tuesday night, starting at 9:05.
Only on MorningShowCentral.com.
Rise above the clutter, brand your identity, and make a statement. Broken Fan Media. Expert video production, television and web commercials, music video, real estate tours, live concerts and events, state-of-the-art post-production, video and audio editing. Check us out on the web at BrokenFanMedia.com. 434-944-0472. Broken Fan Media. The next generation of sight and sound.
If you're looking for the best in musical equipment, recording gear, sound reinforcement, and more,
Guitar Center has you covered.
Guitar Center, located at 26635 Brook Park Road in North Olmsted, has the tools of your trade.
With the largest selection of music and sound gear in the area,
they cater to your musical needs and have the knowledge to help you out. Guitar Center in North Olmsted. MorningShowCentral.com uses them.
You should too.
Need to know more?
Go to GuitarCenter.com.
Looking for reliable and affordable Shoutcast audio or video hosting? JWN Media offers complete Shoutcast hosting solutions for business or personal use. All plans come with full listener stats, custom web scripts for implementing your service into your existing website, full server control, super fast network, and huge bandwidth limits, a 99.5% uptime guarantee, and friendly, knowledgeable support personnel
dedicated to making your hosting experience fun and easy.
With plans starting at only $3 a month, you have no excuse not to get a server of your own. Plus, with the option to add auto DJ and on-demand services,
you can be confident your station will be all it can be.
Custom plans are also available at their website. Simply visit jwnmedia.com
and click the Shoutcast hosting link to get started right now.
Oh, great. Not another Farmville request.
Check us out on Facebook at facebook.com/morningshowcentral.
Denying one Farmville request at a time.
Oh, hey.
We're back.
All right, here we go.
So call us at 888-668-0742. And we have a lot of people listening on the phone, on their dumb phone.
On smartphone, except for mine.
The app is TuneIn Radio. You do a search for MSC Radio, and then you can listen to us. So that means we're pretty much going to have to start describing our videos.
Forgot. Yeah, we didn't think about the fact that you couldn't see the videos. Yeah. But just us laughing should let you know that it's funny.
It's funny. Moving on.
And join us in the chat room, please. We're doing our best to try to chat back live, but sometimes
Gabe is blowing us
up. We're not smart enough to do that.
Yeah. So this month is National Crime Prevention Month. It's Black History Month. And what those two things go together, don't they? I can say that because I was
racist.
I'm not. I have black relatives. Okay, anyways, go ahead.
So it is National Crime Prevention Month. I don't know what you plan to do your part.
Well, I plan on not meeting anybody behind Summit Mall.
You're obsessed with someone, yeah,
and not answering any Craigslist ads. And
I was just gonna not speed.
Oh
no, I'll probably speed.
Wait, what does that have to do? That's crime.
It's not a really crime.
No, it is not. That's a baby.
nobody, everybody.
I guess I just don't commit crime.
Yeah, I think you do.
Crimes of fashion. Not intentionally. That's, but hey, we do want to talk about a couple. I think one of the first things that they should do is just get rid of the state of Florida. I think
I agree.
Completely got rid of Florida.
I used to live there. It sucks.
Crime would diminish. It's probably, I'm no expert, but probably 80% of the crime in the U.S. is in Florida.
I think 88%, but...
All of the old people crime is in Florida.
All of it. Well, they go there.
That's where criminals go to die. Don't kid yourself.
Yeah. They start out here in the Midwest, and then they die killing their spouse in Florida.
So the first criminal that I want to talk about, who is in Florida... Vero, Florida. I don't know if it's Vero Beach. I don't know if those are the same thing. Her name is Marion Searchwell. She's a beauty. Oh. Can you cue up her picture? She looks like a sweetheart. So I don't know why anyone would wrong her.
Look at that beauty.
Look at that murder face.
Murder!
I got some murder face going
murder on. Murder was the case that you gave me.
So Marion is lovely as she is. She looks like, doesn't she look like somebody from the Thriller video?
Yeah,
like she's gonna start doing the twitchy thing.
She looks like Don Cornelius.
Oh, too soon, Chris, too soon.
Wow, hurtful. So hurtful with your words.
So anyway, she became enraged when she came home, and her husband, and God knows what he looks like. They didn't show a picture of him because he
looks just like her.
He's a victim. So her husband comes home. They've been married for 5 months, so they're in their honeymoon phase, and everything's wonderful. And he comes home with another woman. She's taking a nappy, and he walks into the room and says, hey, do you mind getting out of the bedroom? Because I would like to, quote, use the bed.
Okay.
Use the bed.
Yeah, go
ahead.
You know
what? Dude. And I'm feeling like Marion might have overreacted a little bit. I mean, you can use the bed for a lot. Maybe they wanted to jump on the bed. Maybe they wanted to take a nap.
Maybe they just wanted a bone.
Yeah, so she beat the shit out of him and was promptly arrested.
I don't blame her. Like, seriously, why couldn't you have gotten a hotel room, gone back to that chick's house, did it in the car, did it behind Summit Mall, wherever, dumpster.
It's kind of in your face when you actually just bring somebody back and go, hey, do you mind if I...
That's so rude.
Bang, real quick. Awesome.
Well, that leads me to...
Don't you have her twin? She's much prettier. She's
this
much
could be
prettier.
Her daughter, Chris. We have a picture. This could actually be her daughter. They're very similar, although this particular woman... what is her name? Oh, you know what? Oh, her name is Sonia Watson. She's 41. Actually, she looks pretty good for being 41. Probably a wig. Never mind.
I don't think she looks good at all.
Stick them up or I'll curl you with my curling iron is pretty much what she said to Liberty Tax Service, according to police. The 41-year-old and her son walked into the business with cloths over their faces. But when they realized there were customers inside, they pulled up the cloths. Okay, you following me? So first dumb move, they cover their face. Then they're like, oh, people are here. They're not going to be able to hear me. So they take the covers off their face so people can see their face and hear what they're saying.
You don't want to be muffled.
Okay, well, the report states once the customers left, the bubbling bandits covered their faces again and then tried to hold up the place using a curling iron.
You know what? That could work if it was plugged in immediately before you walked in.
Okay. Okay. But then
have you ever burnt yourself with a curling iron?
Yes.
It hurts.
No kidding. So let's just say that's what I'm guessing is that they weren't hot because
I bet it wasn't
she
hot.
Hid them. And let's just say they were hot, then she would have third-degree burns on her thighs or something. Because every girl knows that you will get a burn on your neck. Because it falls out. You know, pain in the ass. So,
I've done that.
Investigators say once workers realized what was going on, they refused to hand over the cash and threw a chair and a plastic bottle at the crooks. Everybody knows that a chair will do damage to somebody. Because that's what I would throw.
Folding chair?
No, it was probably one of those wheelie ones. Anyway. Watson and her son were able to get the cash drawer before they took off. And the perps were identified easily. Because get this, Watson was there at Liberty Tax recently to get her taxes done.
Well, at least she's contributing to society. The fact that she pays taxes at all is kind of miraculous.
Yes. And guess what? They're still on the run. How do you not? Seriously. Because from Florida to Canada is a long way. I'm sure somebody's going to find them. So,
real quick on a segue, I was at an unknown retailer today, and there was a tragedy where the Ohio EBT service crashed, which is your
what is that?
Your food stamp program. Yay! The servers crashed, and I'm at this place watching in disbelief. Once we, you know, people start finding out that they're not going to be able to use their food stamp card, they're just abandoning.
People are like,
there's carts of Funyuns and Faygo and any type of deep fried shit you can find, just abandoned everywhere, and everyone's leaving. It's like,
what? It's not working.
It's like a hurricane aftermath.
I'm going to Aldi's.
Then there's one like really well dressed white guy that's like 65. Buying TurboTax. It was the only person left in the store once the EBT thing went down. So Ohio sucks.
Well,
we can't function.
Are you sure they didn't do that on purpose? Think about it.
It was a statewide outage.
They did the stores a favor by cutting it off.
You would think, but then people start rioting.
That means everybody has to go try and look for a job in that hour that it was done.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah, that's how it works.
So that, see how it works?
And then there's just that one guy that's just like, I just want to pay my taxes. Can you take my cash, please?
Why doesn't he just, hello, just go to H&R Block?
He had no idea what was going on. It was hilarious.
It's like, why is everybody leaving? Why? Oh my God.
Why are there chicken wings all over the floor?
Go back to Strongsville, Ohio. Okay, dude. You're totally in the wrong. Everybody knows at the beginning of the month what that means. Okay.
Oh yeah. You don't shop in Cleveland.
Stay away.
Don't shop in Cleveland the first 15 days of the month. That's
Is
the
it
rule.
15? I thought it was like the first usually, five.
No, usually 12 to 15.
And there's nothing wrong with that if anybody's on that.
Okay.
Assistance. Didn't they crack down on that, though?
Oh, no. No.
I thought you had to, like, get a job after 8 years.
No. You can own your own business and use EBT cards to buy all your Gatorade to put on your store shelves.
Jesus.
You're kidding me, right?
Oh, I'm not. I wish I was. I really wish I was.
Wait, maybe I should look into this.
Hell, they're hiring people in New York City.
All you got to do is figure out how to move your tax around. So if you have three brothers, you just make sure the business is in one of their names and you rotate every 2 or 3 years so you can't get caught for income tax evasion.
That's so smart.
By the time they deport you, you've already made all of your money. And you funded terrorism in the process. It's really kind of a iron.
They're hiring people in New York City now that are on welfare.
Well, so eventually they could get off welfare then. Well, is that what the whole
No, they're hiring people to process welfare.
Right.
There's so many people on welfare
that I see what you're saying.
The people that typically are in those positions can't keep up, so they have to take people on welfare to do the jobs. Which I'm kind of all right with that.
But I'm sure
they're making
them
do something.
Well, I'm sure they're going to cut their welfare down though if they're getting. I don't know what. Seriously, it's always going to be fucked up. So let's pick another topic to be pissed off about. As long as it doesn't affect me personally, which it probably does. I don't know. So, let's see.
We have a couple of school teacher stories that are pretty interesting.
Oh, we love those.
Oh, my goodness. You know what? As a parent, I'm fucking scared, people. I don't know how else to put it.
Well, you know what? I think what it is they don't really, they do basic background checks on these people, but like, and they'll pass it. They don't start being crazy until they get those kids that are horrible in their class. But that's when you should probably quit your job, right? Am I right?
Well,
some of these
teachers have crossed the line in ways that are, I can't even imagine.
Like this potty break chick.
Well, this one story, so angry parents have gone to a Los Angeles school official and demanded to know why they weren't told for a full year that a teacher was alleged to have photographed their children in class for sexual thrills.
Wait, what?
It was going on for a year before the parents were even informed. So the way it happens is this Mark Burnt guy, he's 61 years old, He's been charged with committing lewd acts involving 23 boys and girls aged 6 to 10, just that they know of, between 2008 and 2010. The children were fed his semen.
Oh.
Either like a spoonful of semen or on a cookie.
What?
While he took pictures of them. And not
oh
only
my
did,
God.
All right, it's one thing. I mean, that's disgusting. Obviously, it's disgusting. We all can agree on that.
Yeah.
But he took it to get developed. Idiot. Get yourself a Kodak printer for $59.99 and do that shit at home. It amazes me how many people go in and get their film developed still. So he takes it into a film processor in Redondo Beach. And this was over a year ago. And that photo associate obviously called to turn him in because there's kids eating jism cookies. And he ends up getting arrested. But it took over a year.
Oh, my gosh.
And so the parents are obviously upset.
It took over a year. So he worked all the way up until recently?
Yes.
Oh,
the parents were not. I guess they suspended him, but there was no kind of explanation. Like, so these kids, these kids for a year have been undergoing this type of, like, emotional distress, and nobody told their parents.
Whenever Chris comes out of his booth.
I do not want a jism cookie.
He gives us a prop, and I swear to God, I was like, is he going to give us something weird here?
Yeah, I don't want a jism cookie. I'm trying to quit.
So then, you know what?
Sorry, there's something wrong with me.
You seem like more of a brownie girl than a cookie, but whatever.
Spooge brownies.
I don't know. But
well, the second teacher story though. Oh, I mean, okay, it's not as bad. And
it's
I have
all
to,
bad, really.
It's not as bad, but this woman was a special needs teacher, and she was using hot sauce to discipline her students. So this woman, Lillian Gomez, is suspended from her job at Sunrise Elementary School in Florida. Of course, it's
in
Kissimmee, Florida. She was pouring hot sauce on the crayons to stop the special needs children from licking crayons.
That's genius, though. No, it's
not. It's a horrible idea.
They do that for animals, though.
Everybody knows special needs kids don't like hot sauce.
Or no, they do that to little... They do that to infants or toddlers. I don't know what I'm trying to say, but I feel like people do that back in the day when Spock...
I think they used to do it to make you stop sucking your thumb.
Oh, yeah, they used to put something on your thumb. Like Dr. Spock said, was it thumb or what was it, Chris?
My mother used to do it to my thumb.
What would she put on there?
Hot sauce.
Hot sauce on the thumb. All right.
Well, that's where and how you turned out.
So she put it. So would you rather your special needs child taste hot sauce or crayons? Either way, both is bad, but.
So I'm being told in the chat room that breastfeeding mothers put vinegar on their nipples to stop breastfeeding so their kids won't want to taste their teat anymore.
Okay, Gabe. what country does that? Ask him.
His mom. Did you just quit breastfeeding finally, Gabe?
Oh.
You just pull the kid off your nipple. That's all you do. Leave the kid alone.
Yeah.
Why would you put vinegar on your nipple?
I know someone who didn't stop breastfeeding till like they were 6. That's a long time.
That's uncomfortable. I can't even stand it when I see a kid with one of those pacifiers after like 3 days.
They're like 15 and they have
so annoying. They can't talk because there's something shoved in their face.
Teeth are fucked up.
Awful.
Or unless he's talking about a nipple from a bottle or a nipple like one of those baby
things.
No,
I think he's talking about the breast.
Well, since it said to stop breastfeeding, I'm assuming it's a breast nipple. That's just me though. I'm usually pretty quick with that shit.
Well, so in Germany, there was it was like an indecent proposal, but it had a little twist to it. This German guy named Demetrius Sopolis, I don't know if I'm saying it right, but he found he was sterile and he was unable to have children with his beauty queen wife. So he
put vinegar on his penis?
Yes. Ow, that would burn. Anyways.
Ew, what is wrong with you?
He hired his neighbor to impregnate his wife. Yeah, and who wouldn't hire their neighbor to bang their wife? I mean, most people will, I don't know, go for adoption or...
I don't know. I've seen our neighbors.
Oh, yeah. Or they would go to a sperm bank. Why not a sperm bank?
Anyways, the neighbor, his name is Frank Maz, a married father of two, accepted the proposal for $2,500 despite his wife's objections, saying, "I don't like this any more than you," he says to her. "I'm simply doing it for the money. We need it. Try and understand." Famous last words, because basically what happened was, for three nights out of the week, for 6 months, they had sex. So that's 72 encounters.
Why don't they just use a turkey baster? That makes no sense.
Yeah, well, doesn't it die? We should try this. Let's get a whore. Stick. Anyways, so he couldn't get the chick preggo. This is where the story gets interesting, because Salopolis.
Joe. Let's just call him Joe.
German guy insisted that his neighbor be tested for his fertility. So he gets tested, the neighbor, and found out he was sterile too. Must be something in the environment there. That's kind of weird. So the neighbor guy confronts his wife and he's like, "Wait a minute, I have two kids. How am I sterile? What the hell?" So his wife totally admits that she cheated on him and that the kids weren't his. That fucked up. And now, so Salopolis sues the neighbor guy. This poor guy, he's like, "Yeah, for $2,500, I'm going to bang this guy's wife." Find out that he's sterile. His wife cheated on him. His kids aren't his. And then his neighbor's like, "I'm going to sue you because you never got my wife pregnant." He's like, "You never said that I had to get her pregnant. You just said bang your wife." So he ends up, Salopolis sues his neighbor, and he wins. So he has to pay back the $2,500.
That fucked up. So don't go to Germany.
Breach of contract. That's exactly.
It is.
That's exactly what the judge said.
I'm telling you, a turkey baster could have really avoided a lot of issues here.
I mean, come on. People, stop banging people's wives and husbands for money. It doesn't work.
Well, there's a story. It's really disturbing. And I don't even really, I don't get it. There is a wealthy man that has chosen to adopt his 42-year-old girlfriend.
Why not?
And we do have a picture of the lovely couple.
Chris.
So here they are. They seem very happy together. And his name is John Goodman, not to be confused with Roseanne's husband on Roseanne.
Okay.
That's who played him.
Anybody.
John Goodman. That. Everybody thought that.
No.
I thought that. But anyway, the reason this man wanted to marry, or I'm sorry, his girlfriend, he adopted as his child because he wants to. Because
she needed to stay in the country?
No. It's way worse than that.
Okay.
He wanted to protect his assets because he's got an upcoming lawsuit that revolves around a car accident in which he killed somebody.
Oh.
He's facing a wrongful death lawsuit filed by the parents of Scott Patrick Wilson. Wilson was killed in a 2010 car accident in which Goodman ran a stop sign and was shit-faced.
I knew that was coming.
He's drunk as hell. He runs a stop sign, kills somebody. So he's trying to tie up all of his money before he gets sued. The parents of this dead kid don't have any right to it.
Okay, well.
Which makes him a douche of epic proportion.
Well, right. So even if say he married her instead.
Uh-oh. No, if he marries her, then it's equal. He's putting it in a trust for her.
Okay.
And now she's his daughter. So he's still facing trial. It starts in March for vehicular homicide, DUI, manslaughter, and leaving the scene of a crime. So he didn't even stick around.
Speaking of Roseanne Barr.
So he's facing 30 years in prison.
I have something to tell you about that.
Oh, no, what?
Roseanne Barr, this is breaking news.
Is she dead?
No. She has filed official documents to become president.
She's a dumbass.
Roseanne Barr, who famously butchered the national anthem, has filed official documents to become the Green Party's nominee for president of the United States of America. Barr, who has been waging a Twitter and Facebook grassroots digital campaign, because that's all it takes.
She's a moron.
Has just made it official. She wants to carry the Green Party banner in the November election. Barr says she's sick of Democrats and Republicans. Who? Wait a minute. Doesn't she own a nut farm in Hawaii? Just saying.
Roseanne Barr believes, she believes are not working. Okay, they're not working in the best interest of the American people, the Democrats and the Republicans. So what, you ask, is Roseanne pushing? The answer is simple. Pot. Oh, okay. She wants marijuana legalized and sold strictly domestically. As for the whole Iraq thing, she'll get back to us. What would you?
She clearly has had the munchies for many years. Right. Of course she wants pot legalized as an excuse to sit there with a bag of Cheetos.
Have you ever watched that show? No, you didn't. But it's actually pretty funny.
Which show?
She has a show about her owning a nut farm in Hawaii, and it's her boyfriend, not her husband, but he looks like that nutty professor guy, like, you know, but they both wear like Hawaiian shirts.
He's black?
What? No, not that nutty professor. No, wasn't there a white nutty professor? Never mind. That was
The Eddie Murphy one was a remake. That's right.
Oh, geez. And see, we're giving tribute to Black History Month.
We are. Ask a Black Guy coming soon.
Oh, yes.
We'll touch on that in a little bit.
What a treat. So I think we're going to take another quick break.
When we come back, we're talking Super Bowl, baby.
Yeah. All that. We got the commercials. We got a sneak peek on the commercials. We talk about Selfish Bitch, who wants these tickets for the Super Bowl. But we want you to, don't forget to call us, 888-668-0742. And we'll see you back in a couple minutes.
Yay!
MSC Radio Network has just tweeted the following.
This bowel movement won't come out.
Check us out on Twitter at twitter.com/MSC Radio Network.
Call the show toll free 1-888-668-0742.
You're listening to Morning Show Central Radio Network on morningshowcentral.com.
You're listening to MSC Radio Network, and like anything else on the internet, it runs on computers. Lots of computers. And you know, when you're dealing with computers, hard drives sometimes crash. That happened here at MSC, and you know what saved them? Rectiphy backup software. Don't believe us? Well, ask yourself this question. Are you backed up? Probably not. So don't be that guy and wait till it's too late. MSC did their research and tried tons of different backup programs and chose Rectiphy backup software. You know, peace of mind is priceless, and Rectiphy can give you and your computer system that peace of mind. Find out more at rectiphy.com. That's rectiphy.com.
Looking for reliable and affordable shoutcast audio or video hosting? JWN Media offers complete shoutcast hosting solutions for business or personal use. All plans come with full listener stats, custom web scripts for implementing your service into your existing website, full server control, super fast network, and huge bandwidth limits, a 99.5% uptime guarantee, and friendly, knowledgeable support personnel dedicated to making your hosting experience fun and easy. With plans starting at only $3 a month, you have no excuse not to get a server of your own. Plus, with the option to add auto DJ and on-demand services, you can be confident your station will be all it can be. Custom plans are also available at their website. Simply visit jwnmedia.com and click the Shoutcast hosting link to get started right now. What do you need to know about the Sunday Hangover Show? The name says it all.
Leave it alone, man.
Sunday Hangover Show. Sunday afternoon at 2 p.m. on morningshowcentral.com.
Hey, it's Big Daddy for the Marty Allen Show. Catch the replay of the Marty Allen Show every Thursday at 7 p.m. Eastern right here on MSC. Now, my show airs Mondays, Wednesdays, and Fridays at 3 p.m. and Saturdays at 2 at MartyAllenShow.com. But you can catch the best of the Marty Allen Show every Thursday at 7 p.m. right here on Morning Show Central. So if you want all the latest sports news, entertainment news, and everything else that's going on in the world, then tune into my show live at MartyAllenShow.com and the best of the replays right here at MorningShowCentral.com. Get MSC and get cooking, baby.
If you live the lifestyle, then you
should arrive in style.
Lifestyle Limousine Service.
Whether it's dinner for two, an evening at the winery, or a night out on the town, Lifestyle Limousine provides extraordinary service.
Check them out on the web, lifestylelimousineservice.com.
Reserve your ride now.
330-903-0508. 330-903-0508.
Lifestyle Limousine Service.
And make sure you tell them Morning Show Central Radio Network sent you.
Cocaine Energy Supplement.
Due to great consumer demand,
Redux Beverages has officially announced the return of its world-famous Cocaine Energy Supplement.
It's now available at retail locations across the country,
as well as online at ReduxDirect.com.
That's ReduxDirect.com.
Don't forget to be part of the all-new Cocaine Energy Supplement social network,
where you can meet other Cocaine Energy Supplement fans from around the world.
Cocaine Energy Supplement.
You can become a member.
You can become a member by logging on to LoveCocaine.com. From the Cocaine Energy Supplement Studio, you're listening
to Morning Show Central Radio Network.
Oh, we're back.
Welcome back.
What the heck? That was fast.
Anyways.
Well, we're going to get right to the top few Super Bowl commercials that I think are pretty funny.
We don't want to get sued, so I'm a little nervous.
There's a giant game going on.
There's a big, huge game on Sunday versus, can we say that?
Go Browns!
So, Chris, we're going to go ahead and play this one that I think everybody will enjoy. It's a Chevy commercial.
I can't believe you.
Should we tell him?
No, let him tire out first.
It's a kid that's graduating college.
I'm marrying you right now.
Hey, Steve.
Best gift ever.
Love a car.
And he sees.
Hey, Mr. Johnson just stole my car.
And he runs out of this house and he sees his. he sees this awesome. What was that? What kind of car was that?
Yellow.
It was the yellow
Chevy
car.
Camaro convertible.
And he's like, oh my God. And here off to the side, they had an awesome refrigerator for him. And he's like, oh,
hey, you can probably fit at least a 12 pack in that refrigerator.
Yeah. So, what's going on? My next one, which leads me to our next story. Let's see. This one's awesome. I think this has been out for a while. It's from Volkswagen. Is this a Volkswagen? Yeah. Gonna go ahead and play that. Do, do, do. Do, do, do. Get it? What movie is that from? The big black dog is Darth Vader. He hadn't figured that out. That is so talented. Like, how did they get the dogs to do that? So for those of you who can't see this, there are a bunch of dogs in a white room. And the one dog sounds like the big furry guy. Anyways, all right, we're done with that. So that leads me to my next story, where a guy who dressed up as Jedi is jailed for attacking a police with lightsabers.
I read that story. It's amazing.
Mm-hmm. A 33-year-old man was jailed for 45 days for attacking a toy store customers and a policeman, or a few policemen. Well, this nerd must be pissed off. What possibly could he be mad at? Calculator issues? What? Anyways, armed with one toy weapon in each hand, David Canterbury swung the Star Wars lightsabers at three customers in a Toys R Us store. Thank God I don't have to go to that store anymore. Jeez. The would-be Jedi then launched an attack at police officers waiting for him outside the store. With his Jedi moves, he successfully deflected a stun gun dart.
All right, can I just say he's got the moves like Jedi? The song.
Is that a song?
Moves like Jagger.
Oh, Jack. Oh, right.
Come on. That'd be a great remake. I'm going to do that tomorrow.
Okay. Well, he was also heard mumbling something incoherently. Could it be, Luke, I am your father? No, because Jedi didn't say that, Jen. Hello. Don't you know anything about Star Wars?
I hate Star Wars.
I loved it. Anyways, oh God, I'm a nerd. Police eventually wrestled the man to the ground and made the arrest. Yay! Of course, he pleaded no contest to charges of assault and resisting arrest. The man was also submitted for a mental health evaluation, but he only got 45 days in jail.
He's fine. God, you have a little fun in a toy store. Next thing you know, Popo's involved. Ridiculous.
So where's the eight ball? We're going to do our...
Who's the boss, Luke?
We don't have the eight ball.
I know. We can do this.
Aren't you going to talk about your Super Bowl story?
Oh, yeah. I have one more. This is actually kind of mean because girls are mean people. So this guy named Jason Aaliyah bought his Super Bowl tickets for $8,000. First of all, who would buy tickets for $8,000?
A lot of people.
Oh, well, I wouldn't. Cause
people that have $8,000.
Mm. Yeah. Well, but he's going to give them away to a person that gets him the most Twitter followers. Yeah. So he was going to take his football-loving girlfriend to the big game, but he found out that he had bladder cancer a few months ago. So, you know, he's really upset, and he sits his girlfriend down, and he tells her, like, look, I think I'm going to die, but I was going to take you to the Super Bowl. I'm really sorry. She was like, listen, I can't be with you anymore. I can't handle the stress of having a boyfriend with cancer. To make matters worse, this poor guy was planning to propose to her. Perhaps the cruelest twist of fate is that his ex-girlfriend still wants the Super Bowl tickets.
Okay. The thing is, they what? Actually updated this story.
What?
The guy's a liar.
What?
ESPN. I think it was ESPN. ESPN Radio, maybe?
ESPN, yeah.
Started pushing him, saying, okay, well, who is this asshole? Like, everybody wants to know who the girl is.
Yeah.
So he gives this girl's Twitter handle, and all of these people start attacking this woman on Twitter. And she's like, I met that guy fucking one time. I don't know him. He's not my boyfriend. I don't even fucking like football. Like, it's all made up. So he's had to come back and, like, explain himself. He's a blogger. He's some kind of blogger. The only part of the story that appears to be true is he does have bladder cancer, which I guess he just pees a lot. I mean, it's like 87, 90% curable. Well, he's going to be fine.
He probably has one of those catheters.
But, yeah, there was never a point where they were boyfriend and girlfriend and exclusive, and he made up the whole thing.
So he's just pissed because he couldn't get a second date.
Something's going on, but it came out and they exposed him, and he has had to kind of come back and say, oh, that was, I gave you the wrong girl. It was another girl. She lives in Canada. No, I don't know if you said that part, but you know, like when you can't produce your girlfriend or boyfriend, you're like,
you get a blow up doll.
Yeah, that's what you should do. He lives in Canada.
That's actually pretty smart. I'm sorry.
It's a horrible story.
It's a horrible story, but he must have been pissed off at this girl. She, you know, you're not going to give me a second date?
Well, he was making up the story, banking on no one ever asking follow-up questions, like, who is she? And when people got really mean, he's like, well, I'm not going to give you her name, but here's her Twitter handle. So then all these reporters start getting on the case, and this girl's like, are you fucking kidding me? She's some Asian girl, and so she said she met him one time.
At where? The...
I don't know.
The adult... supermarket store. Okay, anyways,
I don't know.
So I think that's it for this week. It went by really fast.
It did.
I don't
go
even
by fast.
Know what's going on half the time. So thanks for stopping by. We're gonna be here next week if you're lucky. Gabe Simon might join us.
Yeah, make sure you join us in the chat room next week.
He's going to have his boob and his baby sucking on it.
And if you haven't already become a fan of Facebook, please do that. Facebook General Issues. And follow us on the Twitter.
Oh, we're going to have black guys in the house soon.
We are going to have black guys in the house. Black History Month. We want to make sure we pay homage to our homies. So we'll have them... answering some questions for us. We've got three very funny black guys willing to answer just about anything that you have to ask them. So
nothing racist, please. And that's it. We'll see you guys next week.
All right.
Take my curling iron and go rob something.
Plug it in.